I gotta get to my sanctuary real quick, my little Eagles cave. Cause guess who's going to the championship game, baby? E-A-G-L-E-S, Eagles! That's what I'm talking about. I have no voice, that was so sad, but I don't care. Everybody doubted us. Everybody said Foles was not going to be able to do it, that we weren't going to be able to rely on our defense. Foles stood up, made the plays, and we ended up winning this football game 15-10. Props to the Atlanta Falcons. They came to Philly. One heck of a game. Oh my God. Shout out to all the Falcon fans, all right? I know I'm going to get a lot of them here. This was an amazing game, all right? For, what was it, 15-10? Like, oh my God. Falcons get 2 turnovers, right? They score all 10 of their points off of that, and that just shows the resiliency of the Eagles' defense. All 10 of the points the Eagles allowed were because of turnovers. Everything else was legit. Shut them down. Hold them away from the end zone with a minute left. Nothing is going past them. That's how the Eagles played. Nick Foles, yeah, well, like over 250 yards. No touchdowns, no turnovers. That's the big key. Jay Ajayi had a fumble. He made up for it with a couple big plays in the second half. Oh, my God. This was a great game. I think Alshon Jeffrey led the team in passing yards, or receiving yards, rather. Nelson Aguilar had a pretty nice game with some handoffs out of the backfield. Zach Ertz made some pretty good plays. The defense, though, I'm not gonna say anything more or less. This defense can take on anybody. It'll be a challenge if we play the Saints next week, and I'll talk about that depending on who wins tomorrow, of course. But Vikings versus Eagles, that would be such a great game just because of the defenses. Two of the best defenses in the entire league going up against each other with backup quarterbacks who have struggled in their entire, you know, season so far. But man, Julio Jones, he balled out. He made some really big plays on a 4th-and-6 towards the end of that game. But at the end of the day, the goal line stand, oh my God. Brandon Graham had a great game. Fletcher Cox shutting down the run. Unless it was Terry Coleman, dude. Coleman gashed us. Freeman was nothing. But Coleman was crazy. But like, oh my God. Mohamed Sanu made some really great plays. There was a play towards the end of the second quarter that Foles just threw up a prayer, and it got batted down, and then Torrey Smith, we've been talking a lot of bad about him, but he had the urgency to keep up with the ball, and it was batted downward, and he caught it on the run. It set up the completion to Jeffrey that gave us the field goal to get us to 10-9, and we shut them out that second half. That entire second half was just all Eagles. I'm losing my voice, man. It's gotten worse. It's gotten worse, man. But, dude, I saw a lot of smiles from this guy right here, Carson Wentz. Man, this game could have been so much different if Wentz was in the game. But you know what? Foles did what he had to do. No turnovers. He stood his ground, got sacked, I think, once. And, hey, the Eagles are headed to the championship. One step closer to being kings. The true king of the NFC. And a Super Bowl run at the least. Oh, I'm so happy right now. You don't even know. Oh my God, this is great. What a great way to kick off my weekend, even with no voice. One and done is not the Philadelphia Eagles. Tell me what you guys thought of this game. Again, props to the Atlanta Falcons. One hell of a game here in Philadelphia. The crowd, I wasn't there, but just listening to it over the radio and on NBC, you guys were rocking. You guys were loud, especially in that second half. I'm ready for whoever we play next week. Let's gear up and get ready, because we ain't done yet. We are not done yet.